The Ducks looking to snap a three-game skid as they travel to Calgary Thursday. Anaheim, though, has had plenty of success against the Flames, going 9-2 in the last 11 matchups. Ryan Getzlaf has 18 points in his last 10 games against Calgary. We head to the Saddle Dome for the action.
TJ Brody starts out and stretches it ahead. Here's Matthew Tkachuk. Puts it on a tee coming late. It was Frolik, and it's gobbled up by Gibson.
Yeah, it's a nice play by Matthew Tkachuk, that little drop pass.
Found out the last guy to do that was Freddie Brathwaite. He had a lot of guesses. Boy, Backlund just watches the seize part, and he scores! A little miscommunication defensively for the Ducks, and Calgary has the lead.
John Gibson goes fishing a little bit. Watch the goaltender go for the poke check here and miss. And that always spells trouble.
Loose puck on the rebound. Silverberg comes up with it again. Johnson with the glove hand save, but he's unable to squeeze it. Bieksa winds and fires. Perry blocking out the sun. It's loose. Vermette scores. Well, there's the net front presence Paul McLean referenced, and it leads to a tie game.
Here's the play where Silverberg, boy, he does a nice job getting it back to Lindholm. There's the shot. Simple play. I think Perry gets a touch on the original shot by Bieksa. Yes, he does, which creates an issue for Chad Johnson. I think the Flames are asking for some kind of a review here. Yes, they are.
Goaltender interference has got to be my thought with Perry. That's exactly what Glenn Gulletson has chosen to do.
Well, let's look at the overhead. Corey Perry's going to spin. There is contact with Johnson, but there were so many bodies down there pushing on Perry.
After reviewing the play, there was no goaltender interference. That was a good goal.
Here next to the Arizona Coyotes in a New Year's Eve game. Here's Kasha behind. Everybody tries to go backhand, and Johnson stayed with it. Holzer puts it on the wall, chopped out by Kessler. And here's Silverberg, 2-on-1 with Cogliano. Takes the shot, score! Not a lot of hesitation from number 33. He looked at Cogliano, and then pots his third in as many games.
And he gets his puck on a stick. Look where the goalie is. He's deep. He's a foot inside the blue paint when Silverberg snaps this puck.
First penalty to Ferland is over. Getzlaf, top of the circle, steps up, gives it to Fowler. Kessler stops, steps out, I should say, fires it into the crease. It's off of Vermette, jammed in by Raquel. Vermette was knocked down in the blue paint. The puck was underneath him, and Raquel finds it first.
Well, it's an enormous goal for the Ducks, and boy, the quickness and the hands of Rickard Raquel come through in a big way.
Englund and Boll have fought twice this season as well. They dropped the puck, and the hockey game is over. Anaheim with a come-from-behind win tonight here in Calgary. They trail 1-0 after one. But as you said, Brian, the special teams get it done. John Gibson with a 10-bell performance, 31 saves, and Anaheim wins it 3-1.
The Ducks snap a three-game skid, winning at 3-1. They also improved to 10-2 in their last 12 matchups against the Flames. Antoine Vermette extends his point streak to three games with a goal and an assist. Anaheim able to tally two power play goals. The Flames hadn't allowed a power play goal in their previous 18 chances coming into the contest. Up next, the Ducks are in Vancouver Friday, and the Flames host the Coyotes on Saturday.